piece of work that some of you may be familiar with that was produced predominantly by Michael Parkinson, who's a very respected professor at the university, with both universities looking at the state of the city region, the challenges it had, the issues it was facing. And that was a really helpful piece of independent objective analysis, which kind of took forward some of the work that had been done previously by some thinking around by Terry Leakey and others around what the city region needed. So we used that as the basis, and we conducted then a very extensive piece of consultation, predominantly with our local authority colleagues, again at leadership and senior executive level, but also with the private sector, with business leaders, with business organisations, etc. And we produced a document that you've seen circulating, a detailed version and a summary version, which sets out a kind of overriding vision for the city region, which folks felt was appropriate. And that was that we use the core strengths that we've got, and we've got many of those that are detailed in the document that we've got, and the capacity for innovation, because this is an innovative place and has been historically, to really create this globally competitive city region that plays its part as a real part of the modern powerhouse. So that's the vision that everybody collectively signed up to. The strategy was built around three pillars around productivity, people and place, and those three things intertwine. You have to deal with each one of those if we're going to get the kind of inclusive growth and improvement in well-being of our community that we all would like to see. And so on the first pillar, that's about looking at the business agenda, about how do we build on our sector strengths, how do we make those things we're great at, whether that's automotive engineering, ship repair and ship building, renewable energy, how do we make ourselves even better, attract more investment, make the conditions for growth and productivity of those businesses even better. So that's the productivity strategy, very much looking at building on those strengths and working to grow, increase the number of businesses, increase the growth rate of businesses, the scaling of the businesses, and particularly get more businesses, female-owned businesses, because one of the long-standing challenges here has been too few female entrepreneurs in the city, reaching one of the lowest rates in the country. So that's, again, all part and parcel of identifying what we need to do to drive those things. The people place, and you'll be hearing from colleagues who brought the numbers about some of the work that's going on in that people space, later, and that's absolutely this fundamental need for us. So if we're going to succeed, is to nurture the talent that we've got, to make sure it enables the growth of our businesses, provides the skills that those people are developing, the right skills to get employment, make sure it's a really good compact between employers and the mechanisms of the training and development and attracting talent. But then thirdly, we've got to make sure the place is right. We have to continually work on our connectivity, whether that's transport connectivity, digital connectivity, look at green infrastructure so it can be a much greener, cleaner place, so it's an attractive place for people to live and work, to visit, and to study. We want to make this one of the most attractive places in the country, if not Europe, ultimately. We can only do that by investing in our place and enhancing our quality of place. So they were the three strands of the strategy. And that was very much endorsed by a very large consensus of folks when it was pulled together and launched last year. And the kind of outcomes that it's looking to be achieved through that strategy being followed through is a significant number of jobs. Obviously, that reducing the unemployment rate, which remains stubbornly high. An increase in population, not massively so, that's about 100,000 increase in population. Net increase in the number of businesses, but also in GVA, the value that's produced by those businesses, increasing their productivity. You'll see as a result of this increased housing demand, so how do we manage that? But we want to also see an increase in exports. So that was all encompassed in that growth strategy that you see. We're now working on trying to take that forward to the next stage. How do we make this come alive and actually turn into projects that achieve that vision, that strategy? So we've been working on the development of an action plan in consultation again with city regions, local authorities. so we got, as a result to do that, we did lots of engagement, consultations, sector boards, business groups, local authorities, combined authorities. We started to collect some of the pipeline of projects, potential projects and ideas for projects. Started looking at the gaps in analysis that we have, that we needed in there. And we started to produce this initial list of potential projects. Around those three pillars of productivity, people and place, we started to look at which were absolutely ready to go, maybe already started, present ones, what were planned, very much got a good weight of evidence behind them, but also a lot, and a lot fall into this third category, which is challenges, what were potential, things that were ideas and could really be game changing and important, but needed a lot more work and potentially could be funding, co-investments, etc. So that's the next thing we've been working on. Then what came along was, you will be familiar with, is this sort of industrial strategy green paper launched by government. So we used the work on the growth strategy and the action plan to really inform the city region's input into that industrial strategy. So we were making sure the government knew absolutely what our strengths were. So if you actually look at the industrial strategy consultation, a lot of what we put already in our growth strategy aligns very well. They are 10 pillars to our three, but effectively most of the pillars are kind of splitting out some of the ones that are in our more conjoined pillars. So we did a lot of work. We hosted Greg Clark and the Tate with business leaders and the CA and local authorities, had lots of consultation events. We met with BEIS officials to look at where the opportunities for focus are. A lot of their focus on industrial strategy is really picking those areas where we're great at, and particularly the sector strengths. And on the back of that, we made a detailed submission backed by the growth strategy and action plan on this green paper consultation earlier this year. And as we've continued to evolve in this, obviously with the election of a Metro Mayor for the first time, Steve Rotherham, it was important that our growth strategy supported, aligned with, informed the kind of taking forward of the sort of mayoral priorities, and very much linked into that evolving priorities for the mayoral combined authority. So again, the work we're doing is very much to look and support that, to work with the combined authority, to support an independent economic review of the strategic approach. And we've got a pretty good bill of health from Lord O'Neill that identified areas that we need to strengthen. So we're now looking at how do we strengthen the evidence base so we have a really evidence-based city region investment strategy that says what are our priorities, what are the things that are going to give us the biggest impact. So if you look through the documents of Drew's escape here, there's an awful lot in there. If we were to deliver everything in there, the city region would absolutely be booming. But we're going to have to prioritise. That's the challenge.